Here, Shiva is giving wonderful sloka, wonderful sutra, which can give, which can create the new understanding about the life and death, because this sutra is directly related to presence and absence. Let me read the translation. Feel an object or person, the presence in front of you, means that touch or by seeing through your eyes, feel the presence. The next word says, feel it. Not just seeing. Next step. Feel the absence of all other objects but this one. Understand? Step by step. Let me give the translation. Feeling the presence of an object or a person. Second step. Feeling the absence of other objects. First, feeling the presence of one object or a person. Second step, feeling the absence of all other objects and persons except this one. Third step, feeling the absence of this one also and centering on yourself. Realize paramasthitihi dhyayato layaha. Let you disappear into enlightenment, into the state of meditation. See, Shiva is such a great person, such a great master. He gives techniques for all kinds of human beings and all situations. Yesterday, the technique is for people who are in pain or suffering. Today the technique is for people who are in love on the way to pain. He says, first feel an object or that person before you. Understand? Just to see, if you see through two eyes, it's enough. But to feel, you need to use all three eyes. Third eye also. If you see the kids seeing the rose or a teddy bear, you see how the kid feels the teddy bear. He doesn't just see, he feels it. You can see how his eyes become big, big. Almost, he feels connected to the teddy bear. He feels completely connected. If you try to take it away, you will see the fun. You will see the drama he creates. He feels that the toy is just part of him. So you need to feel that close with some object or that person. It will happen only when your third eye opens, means only when your logic is absent. You can see when you are in love with somebody, when you are in love with some object, your eyes will be bright when you look at that person. Practically, your whole being will be looking through your eyes. Through your eyes. You will feel it. First, sit with that person or the object. Just feel it. Feel that object or the person through your whole being, through the whole body, through the whole energy. Just feel. Just be completely lost. Feel only that object or that person. Second thing, important thing, feel the absence of all other objects and persons but this one. I am reading the original sutra, original translation, so that you will understand. Actually, this sutra can be translated in so many ways. I really feel sorry for my poor translation, because I don't have more words. The sutra has to be understood from 4 or 5 dimensions, because this can give you the basic truths of the falling in love with the master or falling in love with some god or a deity. The sutra will give you the basic technique, how that helps you towards enlightenment. When you deeply feel connected to a master, when you deeply feel connected to a deity, to a god, to a statue, what happens in you, how it leads you towards enlightenment, is beautifully described in this sutra. Understand? People ask me, Swamiji, if I have fallen in love with a girl or a man, can this technique help me? It will. Because whenever you are in love with somebody, the other person will look like a god. He will be God for you. Understand? I always tell people come and ask me, Swamiji, I feel you are God. I tell them, this mood or experience will be there as long as you feel connected or you are in love. As long as you are feeling connected or you are in love. When you are in love with somebody, not only with me, with a master, with anybody, when you are in love, the other person will appear like a god. He will be fulfillment of your being. God means what? Your fulfillment. Your fulfillment is what we call God. What you feel as your fulfillment is your God, Ishta Devata. That is your chosen ideal. When you are in love with the master, he appears as God. He will be God. I always tell people, when you are in love with me, not only I will appear as God, you will see all miracles which God will do will be happening through me. But when that love or feeling connected goes away, when you don't have that, you will not see any miracle through me. Even if you see, you will take it for granted. It is feeling deeply connected or love that gives you the experience, glimpse of God through other, and it just gives you inside you. It's a big science. First, you fall in love with that object or a person. One difficulty is, if you fall in love with that object or a person, first, you need to concentrate, feel him, and leave everything else. Then feel his absence also. When you want to feel his absence, he may not agree or cooperate. With a master, he will agree and cooperate to feel his absence, and he will put the whole energy and whole devotion on yourself. He will not bind you. That is the greatness of master. That is the greatness of falling in love with the master. See, when you fall in love with an ordinary object or an ordinary person also, this technique can help you. But one thing, when you want to move away from his presence, he will feel dissatisfied. He will not encourage it. He wants you to be, by now, he will be dependent on you. A person who acts as an object for you to fall in love and waits till everything else disappears from you and diverts the same attention and energy towards you and gracefully moves away, lets you experience his absence, is master. He is master. Master is a person who will not be dependent on you, but who will help you to be dependent on him. When time comes, He will simply liberate you and put your whole energy on you and say goodbye and tell you to experience the ultimate. With ordinary person, that step will be a little difficult. The third step, first step, falling in love, feeling the person, there won't be a problem. Second step, forgetting all other objects except that person or the object, that also won't be a problem. But the third step, feeling his absence also and diverting the whole concentrated energy on yourself. Dhyayato layaha means merging into meditation itself without an object for meditation. At that spot, an ordinary person will not be able to let go. He will create a comfort zone between you and him and encourage you to be in that same comfort zone. Will not allow you to go beyond him. That is where the problem will start. Of course, when that problem comes, let us face that. Just because that problem may come, it is not that we should not start our steps at all. When it comes, let us find the solution. Let us start the work. Let us start the great work of working towards the enlightenment. Three step. Feel an object before you. Not just seeing, feeling. Means completely lost. Feel the absence of all other objects and persons but this one. Exclude everything else. Just be completely lost with that one person or with that one object. Let there not be anything else. Exclude. Third step, when you really feel that there is no object, suddenly after some time, you feel, oh God, I was sitting here with Swamiji for 3 hours. And suddenly after the lecture, you wake up, not from sleep. You think, oh God, there are so many people around me. Or suddenly you see, when did you come and sit? You ask the next person. And he asks the person, when did you come and sit? I did not even notice. If that happens, means you are excluded. You achieved the state of excluding everything else. Then you need to go to the third step. Means now unclutch from master also. Feel his absence also. Then leaving aside the object feeling, and the absence feeling, realize. Object feeling means the presence. Absence feeling means absence. Leaving aside both, realize. Dhyayato layaha. Hritaye layante. Dhyayato layaha. Means, now let you realize, let you disappear. Just in yourself. This sutra, if it is understood, it will give you the basic science of devotion, basic science of falling in connection or in deep devotion with the master, or even feeling connected to a deity, to a murti. See, in Ramakrishna's case, he was so connected to that Kali Murti. He felt that Murti was alive. Just now, few months ago, I went and saw that Murti. When I saw that, it was such an overflowing, such a fulfilled feeling. Just a 3 feet stone can give enlightenment. See the amazing thing. It's not more than 3 feet murti, just 3 feet murti, black stone. It can give enlightenment. He was so strongly connected. First the feeling of the object happened, then the exclusion, means leaving all other objects, that also happened. He used to sit in front of that murti for hours. If he starts doing aarti, people will start moving away, because he won't end. If some people start speaking, you don't know when they will end. If he starts doing aarti, you don't know when he will end. People will start going away. Second step also happened. The third step happened when he became enlightened. Third step means feeling the absence, means leaving even that form happened to him. Only then he became enlightened. Because when Totaburi came, his guru, enlightened master came, he said, I will initiate you. Ramakrishna said, yes, you initiate me. Totaburi said, now concentrate on the Agnya. He gave a technique. And put your whole energy on yourself. Ramakrishna said, no. The moment I close my eyes, I see Devi. My Devi, I feel her presence. Totaburi says, that is nice. You have come to the second step. Nothing wrong. But now you need to go to the third step. Go beyond the form. Cut that murti. Cut that form. Ramakrishna says, what? How can I cherish this form? Throughout my life, I worshipped this form, respected, felt so deeply connected. How can I cut this form? Totaburi says, no, unless you cut, you won't experience the next step. Then finally, Ramakrishna agrees. And he says, I visualized my knowledge as the sword and cut the form of Devi, means disconnected. Disconnected myself. Felt the absence. Ready to divert myself to my center. You see, directly you can't connect yourself with your center. First you need to use the outer object, presence, then absence. Then you will be enlightened. Then Ramakrishna says, the moment I cut that form, destroyed that form, suddenly something opened in me. I am lost in samadhi, enlightenment. That moment he became enlightened. Understand, feel an object, even ordinary relationship, falling in love can raise you to enlightenment. With this one technique, feel that object or the person intensely, exclude everything else, feel the absence of all other objects, only that object or that person's presence, then move away even from that person or the object. Feel the presence, feel the absence. Suddenly you will see you are centered on you, on your deeper self, on your consciousness, on your very being. Feel an object before you. Feel the absence of all other objects or persons but this one. Then leaving aside the object feeling and the absence feeling, realize, dhyayanto layaha, let you relax, let you disappear, let you merge into the state of meditation or enlightenment. Try this technique. This you can do only with some person or object, so you won't be able to do now. First of all, we can't disclose with whom we are in love or with what object we are in love. It is such a personal, intimate thing. You can do it only alone with your private space. In your private space, try If you are in love with some object or the person, try this technique. First feel the presence of that person. Feel the absence of all other objects. Then feel the absence of that person also. And let you get centered on the eternal bliss. Let you all achieve and radiate eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you.
Nityam Saranam Gacchami, Dhyanam Saranam Gacchami, Anandam Saranam Gacchami, Nityanandam Saranam Gacchami.
Nityam Charanam Gacchami, Dhyanam Charanam Gacchami, Anandam Charanam Gacchami, Nityanandam Charanam Gacchami.
Nityam Charanam Gacchami, Dhyanam Charanam Saranam Gacchami, Nityanandam Saranam Gacchami,
Nityam Saranam Gacchami, Dhyanam Saranam Gacchami, Anandam Saranam Gacchami, Nityanandam Saranam Gacchami.
Saranam Gacchami, Dhyanam Saranam Gacchami, Anandam Saranam.